Next step, you have another shipment of supplies going back to Liberia.
Yes, as a matter of fact, I came back from Africa in January on the 16th, and as soon as I got here, we had another load of computers ready to go. The Harmon Parish government gave us over 200 used computers. So that kind of filled half of the next container already. So in the next 60 days, I'm looking forward to shipping another container.
And you still accept supplies?
Yes, yeah, still accept supplies. Personally, we are almost full because it's just one container. I'm looking forward to the day I'll be able to ship two, hopefully a year.
Our Rotary Club has also decided to donate a check for $400 to Eric to cover the cost of getting the U-Haul trucks to bring them back to Lafayette, where they will eventually be shipped out to West Africa.
Hope it gets to the right places. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hey, guys. Look, y'all have a great time over there. This is some good stuff. You're going to enjoy it. We're glad that we can be a part of what you guys are working hard to do over there in Liberia. So, go ahead.
All right. Hello, the people in Liberia.
It's a great thing to be of service to us.
You've heard the saying, one person's trash is another person's treasure, and that is very true here today. All this stuff here in the shed is going to directly impact the people's lives in Africa.
Most of these stuff that you see here today are just non-available in most of these countries, and if you find them, they're going to be pretty, pretty expensive.
Every day Wowo lives in Acadiana, he feels lucky. As an escaped refugee, he wanted to find a way to bring hope back to his people and show them the generosity of his new home.
Like the Bible says, so whom much is given, much is required. A lot has been given to me for the fact that I live here in Acadiana, which I don't truly deserve. You know, so it's just, what can I do? I know I'm here now. You know, what can I do with these old computers? What can I do with the old chairs? They're all in the trash can. They're somewhere in the dumpsters, you know. Let me pick them up. Maybe that's all I can do to give back.
Liberia is the third poorest country in the world. And after more than 16 years of civil war, an entire generation of people were wiped out.
In November, I went to Liberia. And I saw a country that was wrecked by their civil war, but a country full of people who really want to rebuild, and they want help.
Volunteers are working on getting their next shipment of donations together right now. Live in the news center, Melissa Hawks for KATC TV3.
A man really making a difference. Thank you.
Eric's landmark achievement in Liberia 2012 was the completion of the Heart of Grace Elementary, Junior, and Senior High School. This new school facility has 1,500 students with 53 teachers and administrators. Most of these children, if not all, would have not been in school had it not been for the grace of God and Eric's willingness to return to Africa to get involved. With the total involvement and sacrificial services of the local people, the school construction project was completed within 6 months. Every building here was constructed by the local people themselves using their bare hands. It had no caterpillars, tractors, or construction machines whatsoever. This is the only free school in this community of about 17,000 people. The school is the heartbeat of the entire community. It has brought hope, peace, and set into place the path to a brighter future for the next generation of Liberians. This library was built in 2011. It is the only free, well-equipped library and educational resource center in this part of the country for both the students and local community members. This is where the battle against the darkness of the mind is fought and won by teaching them how to read and write. This is the Christ New Breed Center Church, established about a year ago to create a spiritual battlefield for the fight against the darkness of the soul and hearts of the children. Eric's work has hugely impacted countless lives, both in the United States and Africa. Since relocating to the United States back in 2006, Eric has been a source of encouragement and inspiration to many across the world. In the last 3 years, several teams of American volunteers from across the United States have traveled to Liberia with Eric's nonprofit organization called the Change Agent Network to help in the building process of a country that was devastated by 14 years of civil war. Some of these volunteers are helping to provide hope to tens of thousands of underprivileged Liberians who have lost everything. Some have traveled to Liberia as medical doctors to assist in providing free medical treatment for eye diseases and visual problems to the poorest of the poor. Others have been to Liberia to provide important developmental services for the children who are the true victims of the 14-year civil war. Let's listen briefly to some of the comments from a few of the American volunteers who have been to the West African nation of Liberia to help out.
Hi, I'm Josh Langford. Eric invited me to Monrovia, and it's been a blast hanging out with him for the last 5 days. And I see just so much hope around here. You come down a road that's barely a road, and passing folks in just extreme poverty, and then to find a school like this, it's just a complete, oasis. There's so much joy and hope in this area, and it's just been a great time.
I am Marty Thomas from Trinity Bible Church in Lafayette, Louisiana, and I am in Johnsonville in Liberia. I am so incredibly thrilled to be able to visit this country and to visit this school, to visit Heart of Grace School. What I've seen here has amazed me. Change Agent Network has created a place of peace and beauty and order in the middle of a country that is still ravaged by the after effects of war. This is a beautiful school. I can already see that this school is transforming the community. There's a different feel here. The adults interact with each other differently. The children come to school even when it's not school hours. And I believe that this will be the center of, God willing, a movement that could transform the whole country.
My name is David Booker. I'm from Waco, Texas. I'm here with my wife, Kim, and my friend, Ryan, from our church. And we're just excited to be here and to see what all the Lord's doing in Africa. Seeing what the Lord is doing here in Liberia, it's been really amazing. First of all, I mean, to see all the struggles that the people are facing and all the pain and all the trials that they've been through is very devastating. But then to see what the Lord is doing here in Johnsonville at Change Agent Network is amazing. I've never seen God do something so fast. Just in a short amount of time, the amazing school and the church, God just has his hand on this place like nothing I've ever seen before. And so when we see God with his hand on something, we know that we need to get involved because we'll find the blessings of God in that place.
Some also traveled to Liberia to provide local teachers, administrators, and staff of the school and community with leadership and critical thinking programs. Eric calls it training the trainers. The 842 computer training program is a computer literacy initiative for poor young people, including children in Liberia. It's a cost-free establishment set up to provide free computer information, communication, and technological skills to the less privileged. This initiative originally began in the refugee camp in Nigeria back in 2002. The 842 Computer Training Center in Liberia has successfully trained and graduated approximately 6,500 students in the past 4 years. All of the computers in this center and other training equipment were donated by the American public. Eric has also not only used these computers for the schools that have been built, but also has given the remaining computers and clothing, shoes, books, etc., to other educational institutions in the country, such as the government establishments, University of Liberia, and the Liberian National Police. The new phase of Eric's mission in Liberia for 2012 is to build 2 more classrooms, a medical clinic, and living quarters for visiting missionaries and volunteers from the U.S. and other countries around the world. Eric is now trying to raise $100,000 for the materials. The local people in Liberia will do the rest of the work. Eric is praying that the generous people of the United States and Acadiana in particular will once again help to provide the funds, medical equipment, and supplies needed to implement these projects. The goal of the Change Agent Network is to change the mindset of the African people through education and technology with a foundation in Christ. Change Agent Network takes unwanted electronics, educational items, and household materials and uses them to empower and educate the oppressed people of Liberia. If you would like to know more about Eric's works, how to get involved, or how to make a financial or material contribution to this worthy cause, this is how to reach him. Their website is changeagentlive.org. The telephone number is 337-781-4208. And their email address is info@changeagentlive.org.